A third straight oil price rollback looms next week. Kerosene may fall by as much as a peso per liter, while diesel expected to be cheaper by 10 to 35 centavos. Motorists using gasoline can also save at least 20 centavos. The Philippine Energy Department hopes cheaper fuel prices will persist until next year.
Kung titignan mo yung outlook na nilabas ng global crude oil market na short-term outlook nila, end of the year talagang may excess ang world supply hanggang second quarter pa nga ng 2024. Kaya lang, sabi ko nga, minsan may mga relevant news na maaring magpabago ng direksyon. Pero kung yun ang nakita nilang projection hanggang 2024 na mas mataas ang world supply kumpara sa world demand.
Transport Group Piston Malls bringing the issue of the public utility vehicle modernization program to the Philippines' highest court. That's after the group failed to reach an agreement with transport officials on their demand to extend the December 31 POV franchise consolidation deadline. Piston is on the second day of its two-day strike in protest of the controversial modernization scheme.
Tuloy-tuloy tayong kikilos para igiit sa pamahalaan na yung usapin ng pananatili nga ng kabuhayan. Ano? Dahil ang sinasabi nga natin ay dapat makita ni BBM na ang sektor po ng transportasyon ay katuwang ng ating gobyerno. So sa pinong pag-inog ng ating ekonomiya, pero kung tatanggalan tayo ng kabuhayan ay mayroon pa namang mga opsyon. Pwede pa tayo mag-file ng kaso sa Korte Suprema. Pinag-aaralan po ng aming mga abogado kung anong ipapile sa Korte Suprema.
The Philippine Transportation Department is standing its ground, saying the program will push through despite protests from transport groups.
Yung December 31 po natin na consolidation deadline ay final, hindi na po yan i-extend. Si Pangulong Bongbong Marcos Jr. na po ang nagsabi na wala na pong extension at napapanahon na po na yung kapakanan, 6 na beses na po nating ini-extend ito pong deadline ng consolidation. Kaya final na po itong December 31. Ito pong December 31 deadline natin, hindi po, step 1 lang po ito, hindi po natin sinasabi na kailangan na pong bumili ng bagong jeepney ng ating mga drivers at operators. Hindi pa po kailangan bumili. Pinadali na po natin ang proseso.
The Philippines Health Chief urging the public to mask up once again during holiday gatherings says some hospitals report they have already reached full capacity in their COVID wards. Ara Perez joins us now with details. Ara, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, Philippine Health Secretary Ted Herbosa says there is a slight uptick in COVID cases, evident in the 260 COVID daily average case from December 5 to 11. This is slightly higher than the 191 case average the week before. According to the Philippine Department of Health, fatality rate is at 0.33%. Since August, there is an average of one death per day, mostly those with comorbidity and high risk. This is still considered low if we will compare to the height of the Delta variant when fatality rate is at 5%. Herbosa also confirmed that some hospitals have noted a full bed capacity for COVID cases, but for context, this can be attributed to lower bed allocation since there are no longer as much COVID cases. Nationwide, the hospital bed utilization for COVID cases remains low at 16%. Herbosa adds most patients are advised to isolate at home and are no longer needed hospitalization. Herbosa says alert levels are no longer being used since the public health emergency due to COVID has been lifted. Still, DOH monitors the cases nationwide. There is an uptick of cases in recent weeks, but there is no outbreak. Herbosa explains they are not as worried anymore about COVID as experts saw most recent variants tested are just like common colds and flu, unlike earlier variety, which were associated to severe pneumonia. But the official says this does not mean that COVID is no longer dangerous, especially for the elderly, those with a weak immune system and comorbidity. He reminds the public to observe minimum health standards, those we learned during the height of the pandemic, and take routine vaccines.
A Filipino-American nurse in California is now $41.5 million richer after winning her lawsuit against her former employer. The Los Angeles Superior Court panel ruled in favor of Maria Gachalian in her case against Woodland Hills Kaiser Permanente Hospital, where she worked for 3 decades. Gachalian was terminated in 2018 over a minor policy violation. She filed a lawsuit 2 years later, claiming she was terminated in retaliation for raising concerns about the quality of care and patient safety, primarily due to alleged understaffing at the facility. Gachalian was awarded $11.49 million in compensatory damages and $30 million in punitive damages. The State Weather Bureau is monitoring a low-pressure area east of Mindanao. Will this bring rains to any part of the country as the traditional dawn masses begin this weekend? Let's find out from our resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. The low-pressure area far east of southern Philippines spotted 1,490 kilometers east of southeastern Mindanao at 10 this morning, may enter the Philippine area of responsibility tomorrow, Saturday, and form into a tropical depression that will be assigned the local name Cabayan. It is not yet affecting any part of the country. Its trough or extension, however, may start bringing scattered rains on Saturday over Caraga and Davao regions. By Sunday, the weather disturbance will be closer to the country and will bring more rains in these areas along with eastern Visayas and Bicol region. For now, there remains high uncertainty as to where the potential storm may make its landfall late Sunday or early Monday. But residents of eastern Visayas, Caraga, and Davao are asked to monitor the system and make the necessary preparations. While the disturbance may be weak in wind strength, widespread moderate to heavy rains in central and southern Philippines may lead to flooding and landslides, especially in the earthquake hit Surigao del Sur. The forecast will still change, so the public's advice to continue monitoring for updates, especially as for travelers this Sunday and Monday, flights may be canceled due to inclement weather and inter-island travel may be suspended once wind signals are raised. For the rest of the country, the start of Simbangabi will be mostly dry. This Friday and Saturday, light rains may be experienced in Cagayan, Bulacan, Calabarzon, Camarines Norte, and Mindoro. However, on Sunday, the northeast monsoon or Amihan will surge and lead to the formation of a shear line that will bring rains over Cordillera, Cagayan Valley, Aurora, Quezon, and even the Bicol region. Metro Manila will have some isolated rains this weekend, but we'll see mostly sunny weather in the morning and in the afternoon.
The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office has officially launched its new platform that will allow the public to bet on lottery games online. Jackie Pascual joins us now with details. Jackie, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, or PCSO, has announced the start of the test run of the online lottery system, or e-lotto. It is a digital version of betting of the traditional lottery games. PCSO General Manager Mel Robles said they want to make betting in a lotto games more convenient and accessible to Filipinos 18 years old and above, including those residing abroad or the OFWs. The web-based registration is now open, while a mobile phone app is expected next year. Bettors will need to have a Philippine government-issued ID and a Philippine SIM number. PCO expects projected total sales next year to reach 70 billion pesos with the help of eLotto. Total sales this year till November is 55.3 billion pesos. Robles noted that they expect eLotto to grow further, but he asserted that traditional betting will not be negatively affected, citing experiences in other countries. Pacific Online Systems Corporation, or POSC, the exclusive agent for the one-year test run of eLotto, assured the public that its system is secured. They said that they have measures such as data encryption, access control, security audits, and other measures. The PCSO added that starting December 16, 2023, or that's tomorrow, Carmina, the minimum jackpot price for the Grand Lotto 655 and Ultra Lotto 658 games will now be 500 million pesos each. Or that's a half a billion pesos, and this is part of the agency's Handog Pakabog Christmas program. He revealed that they may add another 500 million minimum price in other draws or other games by the end of the year. PCSO said that proceeds of lotto draws go to various charity programs of the government, and with a bigger price, they expect more people to bet, hence more money for charity projects. And that's the latest, Carmina, from Pasig. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Jackie Pascual. They're joining us on the line. And the chairperson of the Philippine Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments proposes 4-year terms for the president and vice president. Senator Robin Padilla says they should be allowed to run for re-election after their first term. He also wants the president and the vice president to be elected as joint candidates. Padilla is also seeking to open 30 additional seats in the Senate, which currently has 24 members.
Panahon na para magkaroon ng tamang representasyon yung mga region. At sa palagay ko naman, handa naman ng Senado dyan dahil nung huling pumasyal kami doon sa pinagagawang bagong gusali ng Senado, ang daming opisina. Eh sabi ko, parang handa naman itong Senado na madagdagan ng mga senators.